Monsoon fury has struck four states across India, including Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Maharashtra, where in Ratnagiri and Raigarh districts of Maharashtra, which are the worst hits, 48 deaths reported from rain-related incidents from across the state, 36 deaths reported in Raigarh in four landslides and flooding, 30 people are feared trapped in the landslide in Mahad. In fact, we are also getting to know that streets, bridges and residential areas in districts like Belgavi and Kodagu have been heavily flooded, with one incident of an abandoned building crashing down. In Telangana, CM has asked MLAs to monitor a situation in their constituencies. Talking about Maharashtra, again, the state which is worst hit among all states at the moment, 48 deaths have been reported so far from rain-related incidents. Districts like Ratnagiri, Kolhapur, Satara, Raigarh and Pune are reporting floods and landslides. Raigarh collector confirmed to Mirnau that a total of 36 people have died in this district, while 30 people are still fear trapped. The water level of the rivers in this area is continuously rising, causing even more worry. In Kolhapur district, 10 villages are completely cut off, even as the NDRF teams continue to shift people to safer locations. Mayuresh joining me now with more inputs on this. Mayuresh, the fatalities are quite high. Give us a sense of which are the districts reeling under tremendous floods at this point, and what is the status of rescue and relief?
Absolutely, the fatality numbers are really high, and there is a fear that it will go up by evening, because right now also the rescue operations are underway. We can say that approximately 7 to 8 landslides have happened alone in the Satara district, and the teams are yet to reach at most of the spots, because earlier the teams were deployed for the Satara. There were only 2 teams, but now more number of landslides have happened. As you asked me that which are the worst affected districts, Raigarh district itself is a worst affected district, because Mahad is still not connected. We have been given to understand only one team of a Navy has been basically reached at Mahad for the rescue operation, but due to the collapse of that particular bridge on the river which connects Chiplun to Goa, there is a kind of a traffic jam, and that's why even the rescue rescue operation is getting hampered. If you talk about the Kolhapur, the Chikli village, is still, the rescue operation is happening. More than 50 people have been evacuated from the Chikli village itself. And yes, the Chiplun is still, we can say that the small villages nearby Chiplun are still under the flood water, and rescue operation is on. We have been given to understand by Maharashtra CM office that approximately 500 people since yesterday till morning 11 a.m. have been evacuated. They have been rescued from the various spots, which include the district which I talk about, Kolhapur, even Sangli, Satara, Raigarh, as well as Chiplun. And they have been shifted to the safe place nearby. But when we had word with the concerned minister, Vijay Vadettiwar, State Relief and Rehabilitation Minister, he said if the rain, if the heavy rainfall continues for further few more hours, that is 4 to 5 hours, then it will become very difficult for the rescue team also to continue the operation, because the flood water is already there. Though people are saying that the water levels have gone down, but the force of the water is the same. And if it rains continuously for next 4 or 5 hours, then certainly the water levels may increase, and it will hamper the rescue operation also.
Yes, we are looking at pictures from Kolhapur. Prior to that, we were also reporting how Chiplun in Ratnagiri is very badly impacted. Also, many people trapped in Raigarh. Situation continues to remain grim across Maharashtra in the Konkan region. Thanks, Mayuresh, for joining us with your inputs. Let's Uddhav Thackeray had to say earlier on the current situation on ground.
तुम्ही बघताय अनपेक्षित असं हे संकट आहे. दरडी कोसळत आहेत, पुराचं पाणी वाढतं आहे, नद्या फुगत आहेत, आणि या सगळ्या संकटाला आपण सामोरं जातो आहोत. काल माननीय पंतप्रधानांचा फोन आला होता, आणि त्यांनीसुद्धा सर्वतोपरीने सहकार्य करण्याचं एक वचन दिलेलं आहे, आणि त्यानुसार आर्मी आहे, एअरफोर्स, नेव्ही, कोस्ट गार्ड सगळेजण एनडीआरएफचे टीम्स आहेत, आपापल्या परीने मदत कार्य आणि बचाव कार्य, मुख्यतः आता पहिल्यांदा बचाव कार्य हे सुरू झालेलं आहे।
More detailed updates coming in from Maharashtra's Ratnagiri district, where Chipluni area is the worst affected. 56 villagers were rescued earlier in Mirjoli village along with their cattle. These people were trapped there since last evening due to the landslide, and as a matter of relief, the water is now receding in some areas. Speaking to Mirror Now, the district collector of Ratnagiri called it a partial man-made disaster and assured that once the flood water recedes, a probe will be conducted into the illegal constructions along the Vashisht River. More than 80% of the town, with a population of 70,000, has been submerged due to the rise in water levels of this river. 4 NDRF teams, along with Coast Guard, Navy and Army, are currently engaged in rescue operations since morning. 6 additional NDRF teams have been requested for. In the latest coming in from Karnataka, in Belgavi-Kolhapur National Highway, the highway has been shut due to flooding. Police are stopping vehicles en route Maharashtra and asking them to take a detour. No vehicles are being allowed to enter Maharashtra via Belgavi at present. Karnataka is witnessing heavy rains in several districts, especially in North Karnataka. Streets, bridges and residential areas have been inundated in Belgavi districts. In Kodagu, the administration is preparing to evacuate houses at the risk of landslides. Normal lives have been hit in Hubli and Belgavi due to the heavy rains. Chief Minister's office has asked Belgam District Administration to be on alert with the rising water level of Krishna River. 40,000 cubics of water has been released from Kadra Dam in the Kali River, resulting in the water level rising now. Let me go across to Srija MS joining us with more inputs on the story. Yes, Srija, over to you. Give us the ground updates from Karnataka. Which are the areas of concern at the moment?
Well, heavy rains continue to batter, especially north parts of Karnataka. What is also important to understand is certain roads, especially the arterial roads, which is usually taken by the residents. Now, that's been completely cut off at this point in time. And also, we understand this is especially the Belagavi-Kolhapur highway has also been shut post flooding, is what we are given to understand by the police here. As far as the high rainfall is concerned, several railways and road and in fact, we understand houses also have been collapsed. Few schools have been submerged, especially in Uttar Kannada district, and at Dharwad Taluk, we understand another school, a government school, has been partially collapsed in rural areas. So the ongoing heavy to very heavy rainfall here in Karnataka has lashed as many as 13 districts here in the state of Karnataka. It has disrupted transport services and also including both the road and rail traffic as well. It has also caused flooding. This is due to where several rivers, at least about 5 to 6 rivers that are in spate. And this is something, an alert, which was also issued by the State Disaster Management Force. And right now the work is currently on at Kodagu district and various other districts like Haveri as well, where they're working on to ensure that the people are brought to safety.
All right, Srija, thanks for giving us the important inputs.